vision today for the future of the whole planet, for driving the whole planet towards clean energy, none other than the Honorable Chief Minister Y.S. Jagan sir.
Wonderful moment, something historic is being created, and we are all party to something like that. I extend my warm greetings to all my cabinet colleagues and respected members of Assembly and Parliament, as well as the Managing Director of Greenko Group, Sri Anil, and other key officials of Greenko Group, and as well as officials and of Government of Andhra Pradesh, and other invitees as well. At the outset, I like to convey my appreciation for this initiative of this Greenko Group for setting up the world's largest integrated renewable energy storage project in Kurnool district. In fact, 5,230 megawatt of long duration energy storage project, delivering cost effective, firm, flexible and round-the-clock clean energy project. In fact, the beauty of this project is it envisages clean energy around the clock. It's a mix of pump storage, it's a mix of wind power, it's a mix of solar together. During the non-peak hours, a certain component of the solar and the wind is used to pump the water back into the reservoir to utilize the water during the peak hours. So this is a project which envisages around-the-clock renewable energy generation. In fact, what we see today would stand out for the future of this country. In fact, what Andhra Pradesh today is showcasing will be the triggering point for this entire country to follow in the days to come, when the usage of fossil fuels would take a back seat and renewable energy would take a front row seat. In fact, this pump storage capacity that we speak of, which is around 1680 megawatt, combined with a solar capacity of 3000 megawatt and a wind capacity of 550 megawatt, all put together with an investment of $3 billion, you're talking about this capacity of 5230 megawatt coming up here. In fact, this would decarbonize the economies going forward. There are no limits to what can be produced through green energy. We're talking about green hydrogen, we're talking about green ammonia, we're talking about ArcelorMittal now coming up with green steel. And ArcelorMittal is also part of this endeavor, what is being built here, wherein they're taking around about 250 megawatt of firm power and around about 1000 megawatt of renewable energy is being created exclusively for that purpose, to supply firm power of 250 megawatt in another state. So this would be a game changer in the days to come, and Andhra Pradesh state offers an exclusive opportunity for many of them who are interested in green power, who are interested in decarbonizing the economies. Our topography is such that we have a capacity of more than 33,000 megawatt available. So this is going to be one project which would be showing the light for this entire country how green power could be generated. And I wish Anil and his entire team all the very best. Not only have they conceived this, but actually they're showing it to the world that this can actually be developed. This can actually be done. This is something incredible. All my best wishes for the entire team, particularly Anil, for this grand endeavor. And any support from our end, from the state of Andhra Pradesh, we would be extending you all the support that you require, and we are available to you. Just keep that in mind. My support will always be there. I wish you once again all the very best. All the very best. Thank you.
Thank you very much, sir. In fact, without your support, nothing today would be possible. Thank you for laying foundation towards sustainability and clean energy. And now, may I request our JMD Mahesh Kohli, sir, to step over to give the vote of thanks. And post vote of thanks, we will be giving a token of gratitude to our guests of honor and the Honorable Minister. Over to you. Over to the JMD Mahesh, sir.
On behalf of Greenco and its stakeholders, I would like to propose this vote of thanks. It's been a great honor to have our Honorable Chief Minister here, really laying the foundation for much deeper decarbonization and sustainability for the country and for the next generation, and pouring the first concrete for the largest renewable energy storage project globally. We'd like to thank all other dignitaries on the dais and distinguished guests gracing this momentous occasion. Thanks again for all the time for visiting the project, for all our partners, all our, thanks a lot for all the Greenco leadership team and the team and the employees working with us. And we have from all around India, from Mumbai, Delhi, and from different places, taking time to be with us here today. We're really grateful for that. Last but not the least, I would like to thank the media and the electronic and print for gracing this occasion. Energy storage is going to be the critical enabler for meeting the India's COP26 goals of delivering 500 gigawatts and 50% of energy from renewables, and this project will showcase globally the foundations of how to make that happen. Thank you.
Thank you very much, sir. And now may I request our MLA Rambhupal Reddy Garu to please step over and address the gathering. Heartiest welcome to you, sir. It's a proud moment having you here with us. Hearty welcome.
Gauravaneelu, Manandari Nayakudu, ee Rashtra Mukhyamantri, Jagan Mohan Reddy Gariki, Minister Peddaraj Ramchandra Reddy Gariki, Gummanuri Jayaram Gariki, Balnai Reddy Gariki, Nandyal MP Pocha Brahmananda Reddy Gariki, Greenco MD Gariki, ikkadiki vachina mottam ee moodu gramalu.